thought we were friends. All of a sudden they start to pretend. Never judge them, never judge them, but they cover again. Cause that's just the nature of other men. So ni pajazama, they want to sit up for my happiness. But would ya bless, no one cares, yeah.
It's a Friday. You're welcome to Vasat One. You're welcome to The Delay Show. And you're welcome to the Queen of Talk Shows game. We're going for a break. The show continues shortly.
Delay mackerel in tomato sauce.
Nampa dompenim.
You're welcome back to the show. Van Vicker and I am a guest for the week. My name is Chinkumo. My China for God knows how long. And then after the way he decided, I don't know what came over him, but he just decided, so after so many years, and he's ready for me. Van, why did you do that? What? Am I that bad? Am I that terrible?
No, actually, you're a very nice person.
So why is it that you didn't want to come on my show? It's like I have time. Some bad reputation.
Very funny. Yeah. I mean, I need to give you a compliment.
Okay.
I've seen the Delay Mackerel stuff. I think it's very innovative,
yeah.
And I want to congratulate you. I think it's fantastic. Mm-hmm. And these are the things that a number of us should get involved with, mm-hmm. because I support you, you Thank support you. Me,
yeah.
And at the end of the day, it's the bigger picture.
Mm-hmm.
It's Ghana that is moving forward.
Yeah.
So in the same light, When I move outside Ghana, or you move outside Ghana, it's not for any reason that you have abandoned Ghana. Not at all.
Mm-hmm.
When you go out there, you're flagging Ghana. So no matter how long you stay, it doesn't make a difference. Because at the end of the day, you're a Ghanaian, and whatever you're doing out there is for Ghana's benefit.
Yeah.
So I love to see people like you doing entrepreneurial stuff. It's fantastic.
Thank you. God bless you. Why? Van, there was a time Ghana, your movie, no, and even Nigerian movies, no. There was this time it was suddenly there was a boom. And let's say like 2 years or even 3 years ago, people were into it. The market was like really there.
Right.
But as of this time, no, it's not really
hot
like it used to be. What do you think now? Say I contributed to a sudden, you know, fall, no.
Well, I think
not a total fall, but I say it's gone down.
Yeah, it has gone down. I mean, yes, I agree. 2-3 years ago, there was a boom,
mm-hmm.
and that's because well, not even 2-3 years, make it 5-6 years. There was a new crop of actors and actresses, and there was a new, so to speak, beginning, mm-hmm. in terms of it was like a revolution, mm-hmm. of the industry. Mm-hmm. So people were kind of curious. They want to know, oh, who is Jackie? Who is Nadia? Oh, it's a good-looking girl, good-looking guy. Oh, new faces. Oh, Ghanaian movies looking good. And besides, the producers were also stepping up their game, mm-hmm. getting new equipments to make the picture look good and sound good. So people were curious.
Mm-hmm.
So curiosity cannot...
It lasts forever.
It has a short span. There's no longevity in curiosity. Curious, you see it, it's done. You know, mm-hmm. So yes, they've seen Ghanaian movies gone to its heights, mm-hmm. and they've also seen Nigerian movies gone to its heights. Mm-hmm. There's nothing really new to see now. So what people really want now is not a Ghanaian movie or a Nigerian movie. They want to see a good movie. They want to see a good story. They want to see good acting. So to speak, yeah, it has dropped
a little bit.
It has. But you see, then that gives the challenge to people like me, who are producing and directing, you know, to make good stuff. Step up the game, get sophisticated equipment, mm-hmm. you know, get fantastic stories, mm-hmm. get the actors to do the job. I just mm-hmm. did a movie, mm-hmm. with total amateurs. Mm-hmm. You know, it was tough. It was really tough because they know nothing about continuity. They know nothing about movement. Continuity was a big issue, mm-hmm. you know, but I was willing to do it because, one, I love the story. I love the whole project. It's a story based on a Liberian folk tale. Mm-hmm. And it's like what we would call here Lady High Heel. Mm-hmm. They have what they call Bindu Sudan, mm-hmm. you know. So I did a story on that, and I needed some Liberians in the movie. I couldn't get Juliet because she traveled. Mm-hmm. I didn't get Artus. Mm-hmm. He was also out of the country, so I was willing to work with amateurs. It was hard, tough, but I loved it, and I think it's going to be a beautiful story.
It's yet to be released.
Yet to be released. I'm doing the premiere for that on the 14th of no, on the weekend of Valentine's week next year. So okay. I think that should be the 17th or the 18th.
I think Val's Day.
Val's on Tuesday or Wednesday, I think.
It's on the Thursday.
Is it? Okay. Yeah. Then I'm doing it on the 15th.
Okay. Yeah. You're doing it on the Friday.
On the Friday.
Doing the premiere on the Friday. For and that, I'll say for
Silverbird. Yeah.
The movie in the day. Then.
Bindu Sudan. Bindu Sudan.
Okay.
That's the character's name. That's the lady. There was lots of mystery around her death. Mm-hmm. But when she died, she happened to have come back. Mm-hmm. As a ghost, and takes the form of other females, good-looking females. She gets in your body and uses you to achieve what she wants. And for her, because of the way she died, mm-hmm. she came back to take revenge. You know,
okay. On
all men who one cheat on their wives, beat their girlfriends. Any man that does something wrong to a female. She's out to get you.
Oh, okay. Then it must be a good one.
I think it's a good one.
Also, 15th of February. And yeah. AIA premiere. And
yes,
of
that.
We'll try and advertise that one as well. But, and then today,
yeah.
You hear the movie. You're looking at the movie. You know, Osha, 5 years from now, 10 years from now, there was another time, Eba.
Mm-hmm.
Let's go back a little bit. Back. There was the stepdad. Who killed, is this Nancy or something?
Uh-huh.
Those days. Yeah. Jagbele. I'm trying to remember some of the names. If my camera man will help me.
I don't remember.
Those days.
But I know what you're talking
those
about.
Those times. Yeah. Like, who killed Nancy in those right. times? Like the late 90s and mid 90s.
Right.
And a movie industry, it came really down.
Right.
And then we came back to 5 years ago, I signed
right.
a PK up. Right. Yeah. It's as a movie person, someone in the industry, I can say you've mastered the art of movie, both in front of the camera and behind it. No, 5 years, 10 years from now, no, movie saying like, how is it going to be? Is it going to stand the test of time? A bit to me.
I think we have a lot of challenges ahead of us.
Mm-hmm.
5-6 years ago. We were all in the melodrama, love story, lovey-dovey all over the place. Mm-hmm. You know, and people got tired of that. Mm-hmm. You're just tired of the love story. Mm-hmm. I mean, we want love stories. We like it. Yes, but how many can we watch? You know, and then you even kind of get confused.
Which
story is which?
Prince of what? The princess bride. The bride of the prince.
You know, it gets a little confusing. So I can foresee Ghanaian movies, you know, going another step. I mean, and I'm proud to say, I'm not saying I'm the beginner. Definitely not. But I'm one of those who are trying to, you know, get it all evolved into something else. So for starters, I did a comedy, you know, with Ejako.
Wow.
And then I did the Bin Sudan, which is a ghost story. You should see the makeup in that. I mean, I've done a scene where she actually came from under the ground. It's not the usual appears, you know, the thing. No, it's not that kind. You know, you can actually see the live being moving about. She comes from under the ground, and the makeup is, you've got her eyes all looking white. You don't, the people, you don't really see it black. It's like an X in there, because we put the contact lenses and all of those. Make the whole thing look different.
And
you
good.
Know. Right. And I'm about to do another movie, God willing, January, February. It's an action-adventure movie where, full of action, is done in the location is somewhere in Hohoi. There's a forest there. There's a wildlife reservation that we're going to shoot in there. And we have cannibals in the movie. And these are things we don't usually see in our movies.
You know, I say like 5-10 years from now, no, the movie no best sign evolve.
It will change.
And then
it will change.
Things will be different.
Definitely.
It's not a best sustaining industry.
The industry is very dicey. You've been in it. It's got its ups and downs. It's very unpredictable. But you see, it's the love for the industry that keeps us going. The passion for it and the hope that it will get to Hollywood one day, you know? So I'm thinking, yes, 5-6 years ago, love stories, the usual dramas, we've moved on. I think we definitely have. And nowadays, I mean, I can even see detective series on TV, you know, that's very different. You won't have people watching those things back in the day. No, nobody even have the confidence to even do it.
Exactly. So, Matthias, the time will change.
And what I love is the viewers. The viewers are now sophisticated.
Ready to
They've changed
accept.
Their mindset. You know, I think it's a generational thing.
Okay.
It's generational. Okay. So the people that are now coming, you know, they are more sophisticated. They understand the entertainment industry.
And Van, I know you were a television presenter
right.
before Uber started movie.
Yeah.
Are we going to see you back on TV?
That's a possibility. Okay. Even radio. It is a serious possibility that I'll do TV again. But again, timing is everything.
Yeah.
So with the right time, it will happen.
My next question, just answer, mommy. Don't go about it. Van, Okala, Ukran, a favor, Wana.
Dabby. I don't think so. I totally disagree. Dabby, I totally disagree. I think for me, it's about physique. It's not about complexion. It's about physique. It's about what you look like on the outward. And of course, you cannot do away with what you're capable of. You have to have the talent. So from a director's point of view, like I am, if I see someone walk through that door, my audition grounds, and I see the person walk through the audition ground, first thing that runs through my head is, yeah, I think that's the kind of guy I'm looking for, right? My next thing is, can he act? Okay. It's not first, can he act? First thing is, that's what I'm looking for. That's the physique I'm looking for.
Okay, but Van, meaning say, because I'm American, you know, but there was this time, all of a sudden, I beg you, we say, when you have cast a young castle, my person may produce a bidding or Ghana. How old are you? What's me movie back when I was lying on my pen? Oh, shadow people who were far from talented,
right?
Let's be frank.
I feel you, I understand what you're saying.
Yeah.
I understand being very real. It's possible that used to be the situation, but again, I can liken it to the fact that we are in the black community. So when you see, go back in the olden days, down the road, when you see a white guy walking down the street, Bonnie, see even the children chasing him. It's just a natural liking for calling an outsider.
It's like if I go into marry a woman, Now, one for better first.
Exactly.
Then you get to know
Thank you.
The person.
So.
But media, I'm just insisting, saying, color now, wow, into one place of crime, I can't be into it. Also. And then you've been out there, you've acted alongside all the big names in the Africa, your movie right. industry, you know, right. almost all of them, from Genevieve to Rita Dominic, I'm sure, to all of them.
Yeah.
Was there ever a temptation? I know you're a married man. Say so you dated any of them or you had an affair with any?
Do you really want me to answer that question in all truthfulness?
Yeah.
You want me to answer the question because, as like you just rightly said, I'm a married man. So I'm going to come on national TV and say, no, I cheated, right?
So just a yes or no. What for you cheated?
I've answered your question. 360, I answered it.
What for you cheated? Have you cheated on your wife before?
I've answered your question.
Yes, no.
Why do you want a specific yes or a no? I went round to answer your question. Must it be a yes or a no?
For me, yes and no.
Adeng.
That, because there are people on
better. No hygiene, sir.
Oh, man, yes, I mean hygiene. I
can say my name in so many different ways. I can say my name is Van Vicker. I can say Van Vicker is my name.
Meme won. Asking a question is like food to me. When I ask a question, and you answer me,
there's this
fulfillment. Like, as a medidin, I'm a man. So now I'm a person, must me the day, then I'm a hot tummy. Until I answer me pressure too much.
I answered the question.
Yeah, you trust me. I know that you're premiering a new movie today.
Right.
At the Silverbird Cinema. Until no, a day movie.
That's the one I did with Ejako. It's called called Johnny Waka.
Johnny
Waka. Waka. Like the Nigerians would say Waka Pass. Mm-hmm. Waka. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I was just trying to get a blend of both countries, basically. Mm-hmm. That movie, it's hilarious, it's rip cracking. It's think of all the words that make you mm-hmm. feel like you're watching a comedy.
Okay.
You know, fantastic stuff. It's tonight, 7 PM. We shot in Kumasi.
Kumasi.
Yes.
And who are the faces I be whom?
Ejako and I. And there is also Boys. They call him Boys.
That's his name.
Daddy Santo, I think. Dada Santo.
Is it a new guy?
No, he's an elderly man.
Okay.
He's fantastic.
Okay.
Great guy. Okay. You know, and that set, it was fun because the movie is already a comedy. Mm-hmm. But outside set, I've never shot in Kumasi like my own movie.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like new turf. But we nailed it. And I mean, for me, the idea was to blend the local actors and the English actors, so to speak. Like I don't really like the segregation,
mm-hmm.
so I wanted to just bring both worlds together. Mm-hmm. I know people have done it, but I wanted to bring it together with a niche, you know. And I think Johnny Waka will make that. And fortunately for me, at the Ghana Movie Awards 2012 mm-hmm. nomination list, it got 4 nominations. Best Directing, Best Picture, Best Cinematography, and Best Lead Actor.
In what movie?
Johnny Walker.
Oh, yeah. It had an award already.
Nominations.
Nominations.
Got 4 nominations.
Is it an up and coming?
Yeah, the 2012 Ghana Movie Awards.
It's going to be one of those movies that you walk into the cinema and watch it and oop, you have and you smile.
Thank you.
And I guess I'll be.
That's how it's going to be.
So after 4, today we're showing the area 4. And yeah, remember, today we're going to watch
tonight.
The premiere of Johnny
Waka.
Johnny Waka.
Yes.
Johnny Waka.
And it will be screened for the rest of the week. If there is demand, it will be screened for another an additional week.
Okay. Johnny Waka.
Johnny Waka.
And about stores in
that
way?
That will be sometime next year, February, March.
Okay.
Let's see how it goes.
Your production?
It's my production, Sky Orange Production. Okay. And I have a lot to do this year. My hands are already full because from the acting school to which is my foundation thing, mm-hmm. and then I need to do about 4 movies next year.
Mm-hmm.
Great different stories. For me, I believe in stories with a spice.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can have a love story, but there should be that little spice that makes it different. Mm-hmm. For example, if it's a love story, the entire story is a love story,
mm-hmm.
but let's say the lead actor is a boxer.
Mm-hmm.
You get what I mean? You've got that little spice to make the love story different.
Yeah.
You know, so
you take the character and over finish the character from head to toe. Even me, a lazy writer.
I'm going to have to work with you soon, you know. I think you are in my thoughts, kind of.
It's about time. I was thinking, I'm a TV producer, apart from the talk show, me produce a fair show, Snigger, which I write and direct as well.
Lovely show.
And I was thinking...
I've seen it a couple of times.
Thank you. I was thinking, maybe, just maybe, I should start producing movies or something.
You should.
But now, maybe inside, maybe I'm always looking at... Maybe I can say, Sika, for me, I'm a businesswoman.
Right.
Maybe in Sika, but maybe in say...
I think there is money to be made in the industry. There is lots of money to be made.
It depends on touching the right button.
Right. But apart from that, there should be a structure. Mm-hmm. We should have some sort of... it should be like a teamwork. Mm-hmm. The whole industry is a team, even though they are individuals. And that is where I have a problem when existing producers or executive producers or directors do not encourage others to get in the business. Mm-hmm. I believe in having... extra people. The more we are, the better it is for the entire industry. It's not about monopolizing it and you want to keep everything to yourself and for yourself. That way, viewers don't get the options that they need because they don't want to watch Delay every day. Mm-hmm. You know, they want to watch Van, they want to watch others.
Yeah.
So, then the more producers we have, they have different thoughts, they have different ideas that we can all tap into, you know, that will profit the industry. So, apart from that, the money to be made has a lot to do with our distribution, which is a big issue. So I believe with this present government, the Actors Guild or those in authority, FIPAC, should get some structure where it's a medium. Mm-hmm. Once you produce a movie, you've got it in your hands, you go to that distribution company and give them your product. Now, they have the means to get it distributed. I know there's something similar working now, but the challenge or the difficulty with that is these are individual distributors who now and again might have a problem with certain producers, certain directors, and they do not want to touch their movies.
So there should be like an
independent body
film
that distributes movies.
Fantastic.
Because people get personal with these things. Mm-hmm. And if somebody has a beef with Van Vicker, the distributor, then he doesn't want to touch Van Vicker's movies. So then your movies get sabotaged. You know, these are the things I'm talking about, that we all need to come together as a team. We are all very competitive in where we find ourselves, but that competition brings out the best in all of us, and we all benefit, because once one person does an action movie, you will see in no time a bunch of them are doing action movies. When somebody else does Mami Wata, boom, everybody's going. So you see, we need the people to help all of us, you know, benefit.
But if there's anything I would love, I would love to do some work with you into your bed discard said no behind like
sure.
the things. But
sure.
I've had a great time talking to you. I didn't know you're such a nice person.
I'm blushing.
Yeah, right. You bet you are. I mean, that's all by it. And you remember we're buying our numbers to support
sure.
you at the Silver Bear Cinema event. Thank you for passing through, Van.
It's a pleasure.
Right. Van Vikana, or yeah, my guest for the week. Yeah, Kwaji Commercial, but when we're back, we'll continue the show. Fire, oh fire.